Ms. A, along those lines, most economists believe true recovery is tied to the housing market. Prices are down 30% to 40% since the peak. The benefits from the homebuyer tax credit were short-lived, and right now 9 out of 10 new mortgages are backed by the government. To what extent should the government increase or decrease its role at this point?
Well, I think that we've got to get our economy back moving, and that will help the housing market. And that's creating a positive climate for businesses with lower taxes and less regulation. But when it comes to the housing market, we need to address Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Congressman Hodes sat on the Financial Services Committee, took donations from Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, and yet the financial reform bill did not contain anything to address Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, and that has been a suck for taxpayer dollars. In fact, I've seen a recent report that $124 billion might have to go of taxpayer dollars just to keep sustaining Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. We've got to address that so that we don't keep putting our taxpayer dollars into it and really get a vibrant private housing market going with our economy.
Mr. Hodes, 1 minute. Go ahead.
Yeah, what's really critical here is that we stop the abuses that led to the crisis in the housing market. I voted against the Wall Street bailout. I voted against the Wall Street bailout because I said we need to help small businesses, and we needed to deal with the foreclosure problem at the beginning, not waiting till now. We should have done it when there was 20% in the subprime market that hadn't infected the rest of the market. And now we've got to have even stronger reform. My opponent wants to repeal Wall Street reform. She favors policies that would let Wall Street run wild again and do exactly to us what they did before. Now, Barney Frank and I don't see eye to eye, and I think we should have done something about Fannie and Freddie earlier. And as a United States senator, I'm going to make sure that we put in place tough new regulations to make sure that homeowners aren't disadvantaged.
Ms. Ayotte, 30 seconds.
Congressman Hodes, first of all, that is false. You sat on the committee that had the opportunity to address Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Rather than doing that, you took donations from them. And when it comes to looking forward and addressing these issues, you have voted very consistently with Barney Frank, and you've also voted very consistently with Nancy Pelosi 94% of the time, instead of voting for people here in New Hampshire.